Hi everyone, welcome to 2024, the very first live stream of the year. Great to have you here. And it is chilly outside today. I know not cold for a lot of you, but for us it's cold. It's about 50 degrees and windy, which means it actually feels like it's in the 40s. So pretty darn cold for us Southern California folks.
All right, 2024, we're so excited to be back and be with all of you. We're lucky to have all of you as the folks that allow us to be a part of your lives and your garden lives as well. So thank you very much. And because of that, we are giving you right now the very first peek of the new deck. Still in work here, but take a look at it. Kim, that's okay. I can worry about that.
Just so you know,
that's
on your
fine.
Computer.
Okay. So here it is. We're going to take a step back and let you see. We've been working on this for the past couple of weeks, not completed yet, but we are super, super excited about it.
It's coming along, and Jerry has done so much hard work on this. We originally bid it to be built, but then once we found out the cost of that, Jerry did all the research himself, and we saved a lot of money by doing it ourselves. And we learned so much along the way, too.
Oh, yes, definitely still learning. And as most of you know, there were times that I had to get underneath the deck and how claustrophobic I get down there and stuff, but kind of learned to manage some of that as well. And we're moving along nicely. We've had some incidences out here. So we're glad we're all okay, just from normal type things that happen when you build a deck. But
That's right.
We also want to pan a little bit further back here. And I'm going to head back there. Yeah, that's good. So what I want to show you is this section here. It's been primarily been the same. This is phase three of the deck refurbishment project. This will start right after phase two. And we also refer to this as our Smart Pots upper deck. So we are going to refurbish this as well. We have some really cool ideas that are going to make, and I'm not going to tell you what they are yet. You know that's how we roll,
right?
We have some really cool ideas to make filming the Smart Pots easier and access wise. And also, we've got some ideas about what creative things we can do with a tree and the deck.
It's going to be fun.
That's all I'm going to say.
It's going to be absolutely fun. And you stay tuned for lots of surprises. We worked all weekend on this. I think we painted 22 planks Saturday and Sunday. And it was a lot of fun. And we are ready to roll with finishing up the section. So it's going to be a great time.
Okay, let's see. Kim, can you make the chat come up? We'll swing
sure,
it around.
Yeah, we're going to swing around here. And literally,
what's going on here?
It's pretty crazy. We've got two heaters going out here, and we are Southern California wimps. Smart Pots was saying in Oklahoma City, it's supposed to get below freezing. I know a lot of you are getting storms in all across the U.S. So today we're talking about new year, new garden, things to do in January, essential garden to-dos. There's lots of them to do this month.
Good. I'm going to go back around to the chat. Cliff, I'll be right there.
Jerry's swinging around next to me in between the two heaters here. And we're super excited to be kicking off the new year with you guys. And we couldn't be more thrilled. And even if it's cold where you live, there's still a lot you can do in January. And that's what we're going to talk about. We're so excited about the new year. We've got a lot of really fun things coming up. Oops, sorry guys, the wind is probably playing havoc with my mic, right? And the puffer jacket. We've got a lot of, the camera's shaking up and down due to the wind. But we've got a lot of fun things coming up this year. We're going to have new opportunities to connect with you all in some really fun, exciting ways. We'll be unveiling those sometime this month. We've got new seed varieties on our website coming soon. The subscription box is going to be new and improved coming soon. Lots of fun things on social media. And just a lot of fun to kick the gardening year off together. So we're super excited about doing that. We're also going to be having increased like garden education, access to garden experts and our brand partners. So lots of fun things coming up this year. Stick with us. We're growing our own veggies, harvesting and eating, quick, simple, and expensive. That's what we're all about here. And if you're brand new to our live streams, big welcome to you. We're here every Monday, noon Pacific time, most Mondays. And a couple YouTube videos during the week. So if you're new here, make sure you say hello in the chat. Laura's here from Southern California. So Laura, you know exactly what we're going through with our cold Southern California weather. Hey, Lori, how you doing? In California as well. And I bet you're nice and cold out there, just like we are. Brenda, thank you so much. Brenda's a Southern Arizona wimp, just like myself. 32 and feels like 26. 32 is cold, a lot colder than we are here. Southern sky in Tennessee, 52, and actually feels warm. Wow. Angela, 45 in Maryland, and the snowstorm bypassed us. So you're really, really lucky on that one. Okay, guy. Oh, an 808 ladybug in Hawaii. I think that you're coming into some storms too, if I recall. And ladybug says, love those continuing phases 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, it's really been helpful actually to do it in different phases, not only for the learning, but just not to have the whole entire deck torn up at once. But now we're heading towards spring, so we're on the fast track to get everything done here in our backyard. So, okay, I want to know how everyone's New Year was, if you had a great New Year. And Jerry?
Nisha is here.
Nisha!
And Kian says hi. Kian.
Oh my gosh, Nisha is here with her new baby boy. It's so exciting. For those of you that didn't hear, huge congratulations. Nisha had a baby boy at the end of November, correct, Nisha, I believe? And she's here today with her new little baby to join us. So welcome. We're so excited for you to start your new family there. Okay, so let's jump into our January garden to-do list. So pop a comment in the chat. Let us know how your New Year was. Let us know if you've started planting anything for January. I know we've already been digging in and having a great time getting some seeds going, but it's so hard to believe that we're already into another year of gardening, isn't it? I mean, it seems like just yesterday we were, coming to the end of our gardening season. Now we're into winter, turning the corner here into spring gardening. So now is the time to get things going and get excited about growing our own veggies. If you've taken a little break for the winter, let's jump back in here in 2024. The biggest thing that you can do this month that is super important to do, kind of still in the off season now. I mean, if you're a Southern gardener, you grow year round, but for you Northern gardeners, it's still the off season. So super important. The first thing you must start doing this month is to start getting organized and planning your garden. So, it's really important just to do a little bit at a time and take advantage of this downtime to organize so you're not so, hit hard with things during the busy season. So it's a great time to start writing things down in a garden journal. Now, if you've gotten your Grow Your Groceries with Calichem January box, something very special in there that you can use to start your garden planning. And it's a little Grow Your Groceries with Calichem garden journal. So you don't have to have anything fancy. This is just a little notebook that you can use to kind of jot down your ideas. I like to call it a jotting journal. And as you have ideas of what you'd like to do in the garden this year, maybe just take 3 to 5 minutes a day to make a few little notes in your journal. Maybe when you're on your lunch break, maybe in the morning, first thing when you get up, write down a few little notes. Maybe you've got some ideas of new seed varieties you'd like to grow. Maybe you want to reorganize your raised beds. You can draw simple little pictures. Doesn't have to be anything fancy because I'm not an artist, but just little squares or rectangles representing your raised beds or your containers, representing your garden beds, and some ideas on what you'd like to grow. So keep in mind, if you watched our What to Plant in January video last week, or actually I think it was Planning Your Garden video, you're going to want to plant things that you and your family enjoy, but also try some new varieties. It's always a lot of fun to do that. So if you haven't grabbed our subscription box, you can grab it over at calichemgardenandhome.com, and this garden journal comes in the box. So it's a good time to start planning your spring garden, even if it's kind of far out. So, and I know a lot of you Northern gardeners might not actually be planting outdoors until maybe April, maybe May, depending on your last frost date, but it's never too early to start planting. A really good thing also to do this month, if you're like me, you've got tons of seeds all over your house, is start organizing your seeds. So go around your house, gather all the seeds from the different locations you might have stashed them over the summer, and set up a really simple organizing system. Maybe you like those clear shoe boxes, those clear plastic shoe boxes. Maybe you like a binder with like the plastic inserts that you can kind of stick seeds in them. I personally like to organize my seeds by the time of year that I plant them, for example, or the type of seed that they are, not the variety, but whether they're warm weather versus cool weather, and then organize them alphabetically within those sections. So pop a comment in the chat if you have any other ideas for how you like to organize your seeds. There's so many different ways out there. So just pick something that's simple, that's doable, that's something that you're going to do. Don't let perfection stop you. Progress over perfection. So just pick something that you're going to do, get organized, and start planting. So that's the biggest thing that you can do this month in January. There's so many different ways that you can get organized, whether it's from getting your seed starting mixed together, making sure you have enough seed starting, little six packs and containers, start collecting those. So that by the time spring comes, you're going to have a lot of those kind of nitty gritty types of things done, and you'll be ready to jump right into spring planting. So let me know here in the chat what you're doing this month to get organized and to start planning your spring garden. And then we'll come back in just a moment and talk about the next January essential to put on your garden to-do list this month. Okay, into the chat here. Angela, I know you have a cold winter, Cliff Warren, and wonder when you start seeds inside in a cold climate. So I know Cliff has already started some of his seeds. And Angela, there in Maryland, I know one of the first things that I started, actually we're going to talk about that in just a moment. So we'll talk about that one, the first thing to start in a moment. But generally speaking, a lot of seeds you can start indoors about 6 to 8 weeks or so before your last frost date. So you definitely want to find out your last frost date and then start your crops about 6 to 8 weeks before that. But we'll talk about that more in just a moment, a little bit later on in the live stream. Okay, Jujube has my jacket in blue. So yeah, that's great. It's a nice warm jacket, at least for our climate here. And it's keeping me pretty warm out here along with the heaters that Jerry set up. Okay, Sharon, I am teaching a class on winter sowing in milk jugs at a local library on January 25th. I'm also planning my garden, like adding more horse manure and leaf mulch to the raised beds and grow bags. So Sharon, first of all, congratulations on teaching a class. It's very exciting, and I'm really glad that you're able to help other gardeners in your area. I'm sure they're gonna get a lot out of it. And winter sowing is a great way to start seeds if you live in a cold climate. So maybe you could pop a few little tips in the chat on that. But now's the time too, if you're, you know, the snow isn't blowing around or whatever, to get out in your garden and leaf your garden beds or mulch your garden beds with leaves. It's a great time to do that. Then they'll break down over the winter months there and make your garden that much more productive right when you start out. Bruce, great idea. I use a photo organizer box, decorated the Grow Your Grocery stickers. That's great. For seed organization. So yeah, whatever way works for you that you can quickly grab your seeds, because really the key to being able to garden when you're on a busy schedule, like most of us are, is being organized. So if you can quickly grab your seed boxes or your photo binders or whatever and grab your seeds, you're going to be able to take 5 minutes and actually get something done rather than digging through all your seed packets to find a seed that you want. Okay, here, let's scroll back through and see if we can find any more suggestions on seed organizing. Ramona has them in plastic photo boxes, but organizing them by season would make it easy. That's right, because, you know, with, say it's February, and you know what seeds you want to start in February, you can pop those behind maybe a little February binder or divider, and that way you can grab the seeds that you need to plant in a jiffy. Okay, let me jump into tip number two to do during this month. And this is something that maybe some of you may not quite think of. Some of you might already have grow lights set up for your indoor garden, but if not, grow lights are a game changer. So get those grow lights set up. Even if you just start with one very simple setup, you're gonna see what a game changer it is for growing nice, strong seedlings. So that when warm weather hits, you're ready with nice, strong, stocky transplants that you grew yourself. And it really does feel good to grow some yourself. But a lot of people really feel intimidated about grow lights. They're afraid of getting them set up, afraid of how much it's going to cost. I've got a whole chapter in my book on organic gardening for everyone on how to get them set up. Plus, we've got a YouTube video for you that walks you through it step by step. But now's a good time to get them set up, and also to make sure that if you already have grow lights, to get them out, make sure they're cleaned off, make sure they're all in working order. So that way, when you go to start your seeds, your grow lights are ready to roll, because you really do need to have those set up from the get-go. So take advantage again of the off season to get them set up, get them ready to roll. And that way you are going to be in really good shape come warm weather. So let me hear in the chat here. Do you have a grow light set up? Have you been using them indoors during the winter time, or are you ready to roll with grow lights but just a little bit nervous about it? Let us know where you're at as far as grow lights go. It's definitely well worth the investment and really doesn't take that much time or that much money to get set up. Okay, let me scroll through the chat, see what other comments you might have for our January essential vegetable garden to-do list for this month, so we can start off the new year with a brand new garden and really get going strong on growing our veggies this year. Davis, I'm gonna write my plan on when and where to plant some sunflowers for this spring. So I absolutely love that, because sunflowers are such a nice, bright, sunny flower. So it might be really helpful for you to think of during the wintertime, those bright, sunny vegetables and flowers that you would enjoy planting. So great plan on that one for sure. And yeah, pop in the chat, like Davis did, one thing you're excited about for your spring garden. I know the other day we were watching some videos from last summer, and it really, really made me miss not only the warm weather, but the greenery and the vibrance of the summer garden. And just seeing that, like, wow, it's so much fun to grow vegetables when it's warm outside, really got me excited about it. So hopefully those kinds of things will help you get motivated as well. And by the way, we are bringing you content all winter long. We're starting to get green here. So if you're in the dreariness of winter, stick with us, and we'll have lots of fun garden content as we go here. Last week, it was January vegetables to plant and how to plan your spring garden. So do make sure you go back and check out those videos and comment over there so that we know you watched, and let us know what you're excited about growing. Okay, Julie Kovach has her seeds in an accordion file labeled by vegetable. Great idea on that one, that you can quickly grab your file and go through it and find the veggie that you want to plant. Let's see here. Whoops, let me scroll back through. Nicole, oh, talking to Charlene, wonderful. Sharon is going to start sowing her greens, brassicas, and carrots. So great time in the cool months to start getting those cool weather veggies out there. Okay, let's dig into our next essential garden to do. And that is, if you are still in cold winter months and winter is still lingering in many, many areas, do make sure, don't forget about growing inside, because it really does help not only pass the time, but during those winter months where it just seems like winter will never end. And for some of you, January, February, March could be those really tough indoor cold winter months. Get something going inside. I can't say enough about that. We've got tons of stuff going inside. And one of the things I absolutely love, I know a lot of you started with this this year with us, is the microgreens. And these are so much fun. Now, these are all seeds from my brand new microgreens box in January. We've got flowers and herbs in our January microgreens. I don't know if some of you knew, you can grow flowers as microgreens. So this month for micros, we're growing sunflowers and nasturtiums, and then our herbs, our borage and fennel. So if you want to grow microgreens with us, grab our Grow Your Groceries box. It is just so much fun, loaded full of garden goodness. Get that garden journal. We've got a cool little spray bottle in there this month, so you can get your microgreens all sprayed up and hydrated. And we really do provide you with the resources that you need to grow in a quick, simple, and inexpensive way. So grab it over on our website, and you can use the code MicrogreensMadness to get $5 off. And you don't have to get a subscription. We also do have single boxes available if that's something you're interested in. But microgreens are great to grow inside. You can grow sprouts. We got our sprouting box last month. Greens are an absolutely wonderful thing to grow inside. I just started, these are actually been going about 3 weeks ago now, a whole flat of lettuce. And some of these will be growing inside, some will be growing outside. So definitely get your greens on inside, or your mini veggies like your Tiny Tim tomatoes. It's definitely not too late to do that. And get yourself through these last few months of winter. until it's warm enough to plant outside. And we'll beat the winter blues, and you're going to be so glad that you got those started inside. So lots of things you can do now in January while the winter chill is still lingering. If it's not quite time for you to plant your spring veggies yet, hang in there, it will be soon. Okay, let's see what's going on in the chat here. Kelly Kim, I didn't know you could do that with flowers and microgreens. You absolutely can. Obviously we're not growing them to full flowering size in the house, but every single part of the nasturtium plant is edible and the leaves are super zippy. So you just grow them to 2 or 3 inches tall. Same thing with the sunflowers, the fennel and borage, and you have such a good flavor profile to your little salads that you're having in the wintertime. Or one of my favorites is to have a nice warm bowl of soup on a day like today, and then just snip off a few of the micros, pop it in your soup for a really nice zippy flavor on your scrambled eggs, whatever. And these are just such a joy to have growing inside. So yeah, definitely get your micros started and grab that subscription box over on our website and you will be all set. Everything's in there that you need to grow them. Okay, let's see here. Holy lettuce, please share. Yes, actually, these are some of my very favorite varieties, and we are adding a lot of new varieties to our seed collections, and these are some of the ones that we're going to be adding this week. So I think we've got Little Gem, Prize Head, All-Star Gourmet, but you can get lettuce going inside and be ready to plant outside in about 2 to 3 weeks. So go back and watch our lettuce video or our January planting video from last week. For all the details on that, you can grow them in one of the little 1 gallon Calicim containers, the little cow pots. It is just so much fun to have inside your house for quick little snips of salads, or you Southern gardeners can grow them outside. So that actually leads into our essential January garden to do number 4, is that there's lots of things that you can start from seed outside right now as well, especially for you Southern gardeners with relatively frost-free zones. Now, I know a lot of our Southern gardeners are under frost warning this week, including here in Southern California. I know Patricia said in Southern Arizona, they're actually getting a frost warning this week as well. However, keep in mind, the cool weather vegetables, most of them will withstand frost. So we've got a ton of lettuce in our garden right now, a ton of greens, cool weather herbs. Even if we do get a frost, those will be just fine. Their roots are already established in the ground. I do still have some tomatoes and peppers going on. So you Southern gardeners, where if you are going to get a frost, you may want to make sure that you do cover those with a frost blanket, an old quilt, a little plastic winter cover of some kind. You Northern gardeners, though, get some seeds going indoors. About 6 to 8 weeks is kind of a general rule of thumb, although you can start seeds inside as far as 12 weeks or so ahead of your last frost date. And I know Cliff's already got some onions going. I've got onions started. A lot of the perennial herbs take longer to germinate. Some of the perennial flowers, if you start from seed, take longer to germinate. And those you can get going about 12, maybe even 15 weeks before your last frost date. So lots of things you can grow. Tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, about 8 to 10 weeks. Cucumbers, squash, beans, all those fast-growing vegetables. I usually try and start from seed indoors about 3 to 4 weeks before I'm going to plant them outside. So tons and tons of different things you can get started. And we're going to have a lot more videos coming up soon on seed starting indoors, how to be successful with that, mistakes you don't want to make, all those things. We're going to have the resources right here for you, so you know exactly how to grow your own vegetables with us. And of course, with Smart Pots in the house here, our container garden experts, if you don't have a big garden, containers are a great option. Even if you do have a good sized garden, it's a great way to add on to your garden, extend your garden space. And I love our little Smart Pots deck here because it's right outside our door and I can just pop out there and I call it my Smart Pots kitchen garden and just grab some quick vegetables to harvest right away. And I found that if I've got something close to my house, I'm a lot more apt to just step outside my door and grab it than I am to go down to the big garden, especially if I'm in a hurry. So that's always a good thing to keep in mind, is don't forget your containers, even pop some right in your house or in a sunny windowsill indoors. Okay, let's pop into the chat here. I think I pretty much covered what I wanted to for our January essential to-do list. With these four things, you can start the new year off with a new garden. We'll get you going. And we're here every Monday, like I mentioned, to offer garden support. And we're going to have a lot more fun opportunities to connect in a deeper way with our community here coming up real soon. So let me see what questions you might have to wrap up the live stream. Any comments? I want to see what you're doing this month in your garden as well, how you're organizing things. So let me just scroll back through the comments here and see what's going on in your garden so we're all in this together. And the cool thing about this community too is there's so many different experts in different areas that can help contribute. When I don't know something, someone else usually here in the chat does as well. So V is starting her onions already. You almost can't start onions too early. Tina, I need to start thyme and oregano and a lot. I use a lot of them. So yeah, those are two herbs you can start very early and get them going. And they withstand cold temperatures very, very well. They pretty much grow year round here for me and they will withstand a freeze depending on how hard of a freeze, right? Jujube, I'm going to try onions from seed for the first time this year, fingers crossed. You are gonna absolutely love growing onions from seed, Jujube. We've got a great video on that we posted maybe in last year's Grow Your Grocery series. You do wanna make sure you get the varieties that are well-suited to your area. In our onion seed collection, we've got varieties that are well-suited to just about any area that you grow in. But you really do open up to a lot of new varieties, and it's a lot easier than you think to grow them. Hi, Terry, how's it going? Happy New Year. I covered my tomatoes from the winds, but they aren't looking good today. Should I cut off the dying parts and see what happens or just pull them? You know, it's really up to you, Terry. I like to kind of keep my winter tomatoes trimmed up. If you need the space, pull them. But if you have the space, I would leave them in and just let them grow and see what happens. I'm still actually getting a lot of tomatoes off of my two varieties that are very cold tolerant. So I'll probably leave them in as long as I possibly can. Okay, let's scroll back through. Debbie from Hawaii, need to get another round of lettuce started so I have more to plant out when the lettuce in my green stock is ready to be replaced. And very good point there, Debbie. That's a great strategy to succession plant. When one crop is on its way out, you've got a brand new tray like I've got here, which is exactly why I started these, to take their place so that you're not having gaps in what you're harvesting. So that's always a good strategy to use when you're in the garden. So, okay, guys, it has been so much fun here on the very first live stream of 2024. I hope you guys had a great time. We are so happy that you're joining us here. We feel so privileged and honored to be here with you every single Monday to hang out and talk gardening together. It's really a lot of fun every single week.
Yes, it is. And now this isn't part of our agenda. I'm going to add this on really quick because I'm really curious to hear from you, Kim, if you can get ready to so we can see the comments.
Sure, yeah.
But I'd like to close out just by having you share what's one thing in your garden that you're really excited about. Maybe it's something you're trying to do new. Maybe it's something you're trying to correct that you didn't do right last time, so you're excited about it this spring. So put that in the chat right now so we can see what they are, and I'll just kind of shout them out. Because I know sometimes we all have like one thing that we're excited about in particular. It's really special to you, and you want to try and get that right. And so I know for me, it's been refurbishing the deck. We will also be refurbishing the Smart Pot's lower deck and resupporting that. So I'm excited about those kinds of things, right? And
definitely.
We've also did a really big cleanup in our garden. So we're going to continue doing that. So please put in the chat right now, what's one particular thing that you're really excited about in your garden? It can be anything, building or growing.
Lots of them here.
Oh, they're coming in? Yeah. Say them out loud then, Kim, because I can't see.
Excuse me. Nicole wants to start a flower farm. That's cool. Let's see. Bruce, potatoes in straw instead of mounding in dirt.
Interesting. Cool.
Smart Pot's excited to be able to hear about everyone's garden growing and in 2024.
808
says doing more in our off-grid white house greenhouse. Ooh, fun.
808, yes.
Let's see. Oh, they're scrolling by so fast. Felicia, excited to try my second attempt at Murai sweet corn.
Ooh.
Awesome. I'm sure I can do better. That's a great thing.
Look at all these.
If you tried it last year, it didn't work, try it again. Don't be afraid to. Rachel, currently excited about my turnips. They are looking really good. Ooh. And looking forward to building a new garden bed for the summer.
Nice. Yep.
That's great. Stephanie, thank you for all the great info. Really appreciate it.
Yep.
Sharon, trying new tomato and cucumber varieties, growing new types of melons.
So what's Eric doing? What's that say? Finally, what?
Planting up a living Christmas tree in a smart pot. Awesome. That's exciting.
Ooh, yeah, keep us posted on that.
Johnny Z, do you have the Tiny Tim tomato seeds not in the subscription box? They are actually not in my subscription box, but you can find them in the Container Garden Seed Collection, the Late Garden Seed Collection, or you can buy a smart pot and it comes with a little 3-pack of seeds. You can buy that option on our website.
Keep looking for more. I love hearing all this. It's just really neat because it's fun to share with other people who get it. So
that's
very
right.
Cool.
Ramona, always enjoy the live. I've started to place borders around the garden with bricks. That's a great idea, really, to make it look finished off. Terry, going to plant more onions besides just chives. That's exciting. Debbie, excited to move blackberries into a large container so I can keep the soil more acidic. Awesome.
What
wow.
Smile
so
Urban
many.
Say? Dog, what?
Where's Smile? Oh,
we'll go one
dog
more.
Dog proofing my garden bed. The dogs keep digging up my garlic.
Yeah, we're lucky there. Mac doesn't care.
No, very good. New raised beds.
Yes.
I need that microgreens box for January.
All right.
And lots of great ideas here and lots of people excited to jump into gardening for the new year. So
I'm so
happy that you were here today.
Loved reading those. Thank you so much for jumping in on that. I love hearing what you're excited about.
That's great. So guys, thanks so much for hanging out with us. We're going to be back next Monday, noon Pacific time. Do be watching for a couple of videos in between. And hope you guys have a great week in your garden and go out there and plant something and come back and tell us next week what you planted.
All right. Thank you all being here. Thank you, Smart Pots. Thank you, Cliff. And we'll see you all next week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.